a technique that uses something called an R loop. You take a double-stranded DNA and you melt it a little bit and then anneal to it a messenger RNA. So you can imagine this is one strand of the DNA, and the other strand of the DNA looks like this. So these are all base pairs coming down here. So this is normal DNA, and normally this would be hybridized to this. And the messenger RNA hybridizes to this strand of the DNA. Now, the thing about eukaryotic messenger RNAs is at the 3' end, they have a tail, poly A residues. It's just a whole string of poly A residues. And at the 5' end, we had predicted that there should be a primer. There was going to be an extra piece of sequence that wouldn't match here, but was coded somewhere else in the adenovirus genome. And I had a clue, I had an idea in my head of where this was coded. And so what we did was to make a single-stranded piece of DNA that would hybridize specifically to this. Okay. And so the idea is that this would tell us that there was this extra piece of RNA at the 5' end of the messenger RNA, that is at the start of the messenger RNA. And this I envisioned was the primer that somehow became joined to this in order to make the messengers and to provide the signals we were seeing. And so we made this single strand. We made some messenger RNA, that was just a crude preparation because there were many genes and we thought they were likely all to look the same way. And then we made the double-stranded DNA, and so we gave this to Tom and to Louise, and I think Louise actually did the experiment. So she did the annealing, made the R loop, added the single-stranded piece of DNA, and lo and behold, when she looked in the electron microscope, she saw something that looked exactly like this. I mean, it was just, the only problem with it was that in fact, this had folded back in some way. And so it turned out, I've not really drawn it properly. Let me draw it properly. Okay, the bit at the 5' end actually mapped to two different segments of this piece of DNA that we'd put in as the marker. And so if we draw a linear, if you think of a linear adenovirus genome, we've got this as the main body of the messenger RNA. And down here, there were actually two pieces, which were actually, we call them leaders. And here was another leader. And these two things, these three things rather, had somehow all become joined together, and that's what this diagram was showing us. They'd all come together. And so when we started to map these a little bit further, we found that in fact there was one additional leader, so that they're in fact a tripartite leader that got joined to this gene. But this same leader also got joined to a gene out here and a gene out here and a gene and so on. All of the late adenovirus gene all had this same structure. And that was the discovery of splicing. This was how splicing was discovered. So this was really the key experiment that convinced everybody that what we'd been saying for about a year was correct, and eventually led to the Nobel Prize.